afternoon and or evening, my sexy compatriots. Welcome to another episode of Minty's Monty, the favourite podcast you all know and love, where you just have to wonder, these guys must fucking hate each other. I am joined once again by my lovely co-host, Alexis Oderia.
Y'all know what's at maximum today?
No, we don't. I forgot to say that I'm Minty Coffee, but you already know me. We're joined by returning guest and probably new co-host, Mr. TFG.
What's up, guys? TFG here.
And welcome to another tryout who will probably become another co-host anyway, Sassery.
Hi, I'm Sassery and I like tubby custard.
No, you are Sassery and you're gonna get my foot up your fucking ass if you make that joke again.
Big sauce.
God, all pre-stream, you had to annoy us with this shit.
Yes, I did. I did.
Yes. And now he'll do it all post-stream too, and during stream.
How can he do it post? Oh. I'm not dealing with this shit today, Alexa. We're going to get through this podcast, and we're going to get through it properly. Get it?
We
probably could have cut like 15 minutes off the last one if you hadn't just been joking around all the fucking time.
Hey, I like to have fun. What can I say?
Yeah, you can have fun without delay. Oh, right.
You know You're what you also now. Like?
No, you know what? You can shut the fuck up, because we're going to get started.
Tubby custard.
Shut up! Right.
All right, so what's the topic today?
If you would let me get to it.
Sure.
Right. Okay, right. So TFG's got nothing to fucking say. Oh, God. Right, so we're going to be talking about the heavy update. What do we expect? What do we want? What do we hope? Things like that.
Weight loss.
Yeah, the hope we're going to expect. Because it's definitely not happening.
Do you just want to take over? Do you just want to take over the podcast? Yeah, we can just go total anarchy.
I'm sorry. That caught me completely off guard. Yeah, it was wow. So well placed.
Fucking hell.
Fucking hell.
Right. back on track.
These 15 weight loss tips will shock you.
Oh, come the fuck on.
Soldiers hate him. Learn how he lost 300 pounds in half a minute.
Why soldier? Why would soldier hate him?
Because he's a fucking communist.
Yeah,
remember?
Soldier already hates him. Who would hate him for losing weight? Probably the medic.
That was
because
clever.
The scout, because he's always calling him
everybody,
fat.
Everybody loses weight in communist Russia because everybody starves.
Oh, hardy, hardy, ha. Right. So, first, we're going to talk about the current... Jesus Christ, calm the fuck down! Oh my God! Right. No!
No? Right.
Calm down. Okay. Before we get into the heavy update itself, we're going to talk about our thoughts on the current state of heavy, as in current, as in modern day. And what I'm going to say is that heavy is in a pretty meh state. He's better than Pyro, obviously, but this isn't about Pyro. So... Heavy, in his own context, is quite undervalued. He's a specialist class. He's got the highest DPS in the game, and yet he barely gets the chance to make use of it. You know?
He really doesn't.
It's kind of sad. Highest health and highest raw DPS, actually. That's a nasty combo, and yet he's that slow, and he's that fucking easy to kill. It's just... Oh, God. And so many of his unlocks are just so pointless, because if you're not using stock... Sandwich and either gloves are running urgently or fist of steel. It's like, why even bother?
I mean, Tomislav's a good contender, but we'll get to that.
Thomas, I use Tomislav all the time. I really like the speed, and it's pretty good.
Yeah, it can it's be like a good degree, contender for like, stock, but
like the stock, yeah. I would say, like going back to Pyro, like oh the stock God. Is like the staff flamethrower, and the degreaser is kind of like the Tomislav.
Tomislav, yeah, I see. It's basically the good second option.
Yeah, it's like the faster, and, like less damaging option.
According to the Wikipedia, he's got exactly 19 weapons, including stock, not counting reskins, but only 3 of them are actually usable.
Does the wiki say that as well?
I mean,
no,
if
it doesn't
you...
say that. But...
Oh, God. I mean, like...
You just said it in such a convincing
Tomislav,
way.
Tomislav, this banana's pretty useful, like, not in competitive, yeah, but...
No, like, but the banana's fantastic. It's like, the only good weapon.
Not in comp, but in Highlander, like, you need your medic to get a medium.
Oh, yeah.
Or your medic's gonna be bad, like, this is what you gave me? Are you really...
She's just like a fucking banana?
You gave me? like, I deserve more than this.
The medic wants that meat. He doesn't want some fucking banana up his ass.
I want that BLT with the triple layer, and I don't want a fucking potassium stick.
He wants a balanced lunch.
You'd think that medic would just want the raw meat, but he wants to, you know, he wants to have a nice bit of dinner before he gets fucked!
He wants to sink his teeth into some real food.
Jesus Christ. Right.
Like Subway.
So, any other thoughts on current state of heavy? Like,
me personally, like, taking both casual and comp into consideration, like, for me, he's pretty balanced besides, like, one weapon in particular, which is really annoying, Natasha. But, like, he's pretty balanced all around. He's just kind of boring.
Boring. Nah, that,
like, that's the best way I describe him. Like, balanced but boring.
Balanced but
boring. Now, when you say balanced, do you mean not overpowered? Or actually...
Like, not overpowered. Yeah, he's not overpowered. Like, he can be, like, powerful. He's not necessarily underpowered.
But, like, in this context, does balanced also mean viable?
Highlander, it's pretty important.
Well,
Six is a whole different game because Six is more about mobility and like DM. Yeah. Well, Highlander is more about like teamwork and coordination.
Yeah.
So I would say
have to consider regardless of the way that the game is played and either casual or competitive, you have to consider that the heavy his combat strength changes with the way that his team supports him. If a lone heavy on his own can be easily countered.
Fucking
heavy with like three medics, two pyros, and two demon lobbing grenades, you know, in the back line there, like a fucking war front moving through, is probably gonna just annihilate you.
Yeah. Well, like, that's him in Highlander. Like, Highlander, the only thing the heavy really has to worry about is the sniper, because, you know, headshots. Spy's not really pyro, because, like, you know, pyros exist to protect them and shit.
Right, right.
In sixes,
if you're talking about sixes, like, you'll usually see him run on last. Hold up.
I think Mr. TFG had something to say.
Oh, I've forgotten what I was going to say.
Oh, God.
Was it about Tubby Custard?
No, it was not about Tubby Custard. It's about the tubby fat piece of shit Russian man!
I think I was going to say something about how
you yell out Tubby Custard.
Imagine the heavy update drops right now and it's called the Tubby Custard update.
Yes. That's a new lunchbox that's a new lunchbox.
Okay,
throw it at your medic. He gains 500 overheal.
Okay, TFG, your thoughts on current state of heavy, like in general?
I mean, if you just look at the last few updates or over the last few years, he's gotten nothing but nerfs, and it's kind of a raw deal for heavy. In general, he's just not fun to play, and I think that's really one thing that TF team needs to work on.
Yeah,
the Brass Beast is a wonderful looking weapon, and it's just not good in any situation.
Why is it always the sexiest weapons that are like the worst to use, honestly?
Right?
Okay, like, so I know here, Teletubbies have their own Wikia, I'm just saying.
What?
There's a wiki page devoted to Tubby Custard.
Who the fuck gives a shit? Who gives a rat's ass? Okay, we're gonna move on. Alright, so sort of a general consensus is that we think either heavy is balanced but not fun. I mean, we have to consider balanced and viable as two different things altogether, because they're kind of mutually exclusive in a way. He's definitely not viable, I'd say. Mr. TFG, I can hear echo from you, by the way.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Nice going.
No, I had nothing to say.
Okay. No, there's a bit of echo coming. Okay, that's better. He's definitely not viable unless you consider Highlander, but I mean, Highlander's kind of a meme anyway.
Boy.
What? Are you a Highlander defender?
Yes.
Yes. What, don't you play Sixes?
I played two seasons of it, and I'm on my third. Of course I'm going to defend it.
I've got a virtue signal about how much I play competitive.
I have a participation medal.
I have a participation medal. You culturally appropriated that medal. Thank you very much. Okay, we're going to move on to current weapons. So, we're going to take a look at some of the most controversial
heavy... Are we just going to go down the line?
No, we won't look at every heavy weapon. There's no need to. We'll take a look at some of the most iconic, infamous, controversial heavy weapons, guys. And then sort of discuss... what we think and how they should if they need to be changed. And I think a great place to start is Natasha.
Broke as fuck.
Yes, my thoughts exactly.
Really
unfun and kind of broken.
So, is this going to be a gang war where I'm the only one defending it?
Yes.
Wow.
I think so.
Wow.
I'm gonna...
Pretty much.
Okay. Like, I don't see how you can defend a weapon that's a flat-out hit stun that you can't really...
Oh, alright then, motherfuckers. Okay, let's see where we can go with this. Okay, so the Natasha is a pretty interesting side grade that sacrifices... I think it's damage and firing speed, if I recall right.
It fires slower, it fires with less damage, but the absolute...
No, it doesn't fire slower. It fires...
It does. It has a slight... It has a slower spin-up penalty.
Yeah. And it does less damage. But it applies a bit of stun when you hit people, based on distance, I'm pretty sure. So, like, the further
I've got the wiki.
You are,
I can tell you exactly what it says.
You, the fucking fact man. The bald fact man.
Alright, let's see. On hit, 100% chance to slow down target. Slows down the further they are away. 20% damage resistance while spun up.
If under 50%
if the player
health.
Is below...
Yeah,
if,
yeah.
Yes, below... Thank you, Minty. And then Natasha's bullets are 25% weaker than the default minigun. The weapon has a 30% increased spin-up time, meaning that it takes longer?
Yeah. So, I don't see the problem. I mean, I can see why people think the hit stun is unfun, because anything that's not exactly just, bullets kill people, anything that's not a simple mechanic like that in a first-person shooter gets hated on these days. Can't have projectiles, can't have stun, can't have AoE, can't have any of that shit. We just need to have Call of Duty bullets, simple as that. But aside from the meme-y shit, it's really not that bad. It's not as if you're facing the old Sandman. It's, you know, the fact that the slow is a lot less when the heavy's really far away, and if he's close, he's gonna kill you anyway, so the slow's kind of irrelevant.
That just, like, it can still screw up, like, rocket jumping and sticky jumping a whole lot.
Here's the thing that I see often from heavy that people don't seem to regard very much well. You're already taking a fair share of knockback from his minigun anyway. The slowdown effect already factors greatly into that, because the knockback ramp up with that is humongous. Like, you go from being able to move, being able to move out of harm's way, to not being able to move at all. It's ridiculous. I mean, like, take it for instance for me. I mean, with the way that lag compensation works, it's no wonder that a lot of times when you die to an Nastasha Heavy, it's often the times around a corner, up on a ledge, where he shouldn't really be able to hit you anyway, because lag compensation is just a wonderful fucking beat.
When you mentioned the Sandman, like, the difference is, like, at least the Sandman, had to take some aim. Then Natasha's pretty brain dead as it is. At least the Sandman had to take a little bit more of aim.
Oh yeah, that gets into the whole debate of whether hit scan or projectiles are harder to aim, which nobody can agree on.
Sandman, like, it had, like, a ball and stuff, and you had to aim and time it because it had an arc and whatnot.
Got the ball,
but, like,
back.
Got
the ball back.
If you do that, I'm gonna keep yelling out Toby Custard randomly.
I'm just saying. Maybe don't rocket jump over. Can you just not rocket jump over the heavy? Isn't it as simple as that?
I mean,
it's a bit hard to, because, like, once you get hit, it moves. It, like, screws up your momentum immensely, even with Mantreds.
Good lord!
Even if you're running, like, Trolls or something. It's a pretty brain dead weapon as it is. Like, wow, you don't really have to play heavy all that differently. And guess what? You get to slow people and ensure that they're not getting out of there alive. At least with, like, the stock minigun or the Thomas Slap or any other minigun.
Minigun.
I was saying minigun, but whatever. At least with those ones, you have a chance of escaping, but, like, once you hit, like, one or two times by Natasha, you are a dead man. You aren't getting out of there.
But this whole, it's brain dead as is, but what minigun does change the way you play heavy, honestly?
You could argue that the Samoslav allows you to be a bit more aggressive. The Natasha, it's especially on defense, that there's a reason why, like, the it's really stupid on defense. Really. It makes pushing
I won't lie, stupid I can't help fun. But agree with that.
Stupid fun? I don't see what's so fun about what's so unfun about.
I don't know, like literally having all your movement in a game that's revolves around a lot of movement, like rocket jumping, scout double jump, sticky jumping and whatnot.
So here's what I do. I do a big ass two rocket wall jump over the heavy before he can get the shot on me.
It's bull not that hard to track his heavy.
Bull fucking shit.
You literally have to move your mouse and aim slightly in that direction and one bullet will hit because it's like bullet spread on heavy and just how fast it fires.
Oh man. Oh boy. Okay, we're gonna have to agree to disagree on that one, I suppose. Thinking of banned weapons, at least not in Highlander.
Highlander, but... no, he doesn't got anyone.
Not Highlander, yeah, I'm thinking of, just in general, any other infamous heavy infamous? I tell you what, gloves are running urgently, because that's been hotly debated since it was reworked. Like, do we miss
Gru
the old...
Gru is not banned anywhere.
Yeah, forget being banned or not, but like just straight up, like, do we miss the old Gru, or do we think it's better?
I kind of miss the old Gru, because...
Of miss it, but I understand why it was needed to be nerfed. It, like, just allowing heavies to move that fast, like, heavies kind of bounce around being slow and big, but, like, allowing him to move fast and, like, get up... Like, in sixes, I don't play much of it, but I know people who do play sixes, and... Just generally, when they say, like, getting a heavy to get anywhere on the map is kind of stupid outside of last because, well, now you have a heavy in mid. That's not going to end well. Like, you're either forced to run a heavy of your own or...
Yeah, but you have to consider, you know, with a heavy, the way the gloves of running urgently used to work is that you were marked for death when you... had the gloves out, and for a short time after you
put
them away.
Yeah, but you could, like, if you were running, like, a medic, and with heavies already, like, high health, like, and with a medic, because you probably will be, like, healed, it kind of, it doesn't necessarily get rid of it, it lessens the impact, and you could still, like, switch off of it while getting the upside of getting to mid.
Yeah,
and mid's kind of an important thing in sixes.
Yeah, and I mean, even if you take away the medic, like, Say it's just a rollout. Say you're using it to roll out to mid. You put it away just before you get to the actual mid point. That makes the whole marked for death thing irrelevant.
Exactly.
It kind of makes it redundant because, you know, that's why the
mid
post
fights,
change.
Like,
sorry,
mid fights. They're supposed to be kind of like complex. You got soldiers bombing, scouts flanking, whatnot. Demos spamming the point. But just having a heavy who could just brain dead, like just kill any scout that gets near him, kill anything that gets near his med, bombing soldiers, anything else. It's kind of really stupid, so you're forced to run your own heavy and basically have two heavies kind of just duke it out with a medic, and that just gets
it's
really
more understandable
boring.
In Highlander, because you expect...
In Highlander, because
you expect
have,
all
of
the
more...
frontline classes to be there at the same time.
Yeah, there's a lot more, like, and also there's a lot more damage output, just being, like, output, because you have heavies, you got... Since you have more classes, there's going to be a lot more damage that can be focused on you, so it's a lot easier to deal with heavy.
I mean, this is why the post-change Gru makes it so that even if you use it for a roll, like, you have to wait a bit before you can actually go in, because it reduces your max health, So
I think, personally, I think the max health is a bit, like, the decay of going down to 100, I think it's a bit unnecessary, because that means you can get one shot by...
I would argue that if they're intent on keeping the max penalty or whatnot, the max health penalty thing, whatever, I would recommend that they change it to where it only drains down to about 150 instead of
straight up 125. I don't like the 101 because it, like, puts you to the 100 threshold.
Well, the 150
one shot by soldiers, scouts, and demos.
Right, but at the same, like, here's my thing about it though. Like, the 150 is high enough to where it's above the 100 threshold, but low enough to where he can be taken out by a sniper if need be. If he's caught out in
the
open.
125. I'm kind of using, like, kind of scout as kind of a basis for that because, like, okay, you got the speed, you get pretty fast. You're not as fast as a scout. You got the same health, but. You get to mid fast and, like, so you have the health of a scout and more damage, just not as fast as getting to mid, so that seems a bit fair, because, I don't know, being one shot by pipes at, like, anything at 100 health as heavy, I think that's a bit too much. Like, even for the speed, boost it gives you. I think this is a bit too much, 125 or 150.
You lose that health really fucking fast. Isn't it like 10 a second?
Yeah, that's the thing. So I think like 125 or 150 would be a bit more balanced in my opinion.
All right, so we'll do like a couple more before we get into like new weapons we want to see. Any other weapons anyone thinks we should discuss? Like, what really needs to be changed for heavy? Like, priority.
I think the shotgun slot needs to be usable other than just for food. Like, there needs to be
a good... One thing I always thought that was a clever idea. I forgot. I think it was Rob the Awesome who said this. I don't know. But, they said, like, make the lunchbox kind of like a PDA. It's got its own slot, and then have the shotguns in another.
That'd be a bit overpowered, because then you'd have fucking heavies just rolling up to the battlefield with both shotgun secondary weapons and...
Yeah, but shotguns, not as overpowered as it is already. It's not too powerful in the arms of a heavy.
I don't think that, because maybe back in the day, because the whole reason heavy had a shotgun in the first place...
It's allowing to stay mobile.
No. Hey, shush. Shush. Old man. I'm an old man speaking here. The point is, back in the old days, you couldn't move while you were spun up. So you needed the shotgun to be able to move around at all, to keep on the move while attacking, to keep with your team. Because if you spun up, you were locked in place. So back then it had a purpose, but now it really doesn't. Like, the shotguns are fun on heavy, don't get me wrong, but they don't serve any, like, actual serious purpose, because the purpose of the lunchbox items are just vastly superior.
Well, the only way, like, I could see them be viable, like, I've heard people say, hey, make a really, like, good shotgun and stuff, like, just buff the shotguns. That's just a bad idea.
His shotguns aren't even bad. It's not even the problem.
Yeah, I know. The shotgun's a really good weapon. It's just that it's overshadowed.
Hang on, TFG was saying something. There's just one flaw with your argument there. The Sandwich came out in 2008.
Right.
But the Family Business came out in 2011. So I believe that if it was just a slot filter, then the Family Business would not have existed at all.
I mean, it was more for the set, but okay.
That's why
the Family Business exists. The whole, like, mafia heavy thing with the Capper and the Family Business, Thomas Love and the Eviction Notice.
I mean, yeah, and I like the Family Business, but like,
I think it's a really fun gun.
It's a fun
shotgun, but I don't think it's multi-class.
Yeah, I just don't think it speaks to the viability of shotguns on heavy, because you still see the lunchbox items run more, because just overall they're more viable. I'd like to see.
But dismissing the shotgun outright as a slot filter seems dishonest.
As a slot filter, sorry, what do you mean by that?
Slot filler.
Oh, right. That's not me trying to say that, like, the Sandwich is pretty much heavy stock. I wouldn't say like that. But, like...
It kind of is at this point.
It kind of is, but like, it's not. But, like, I want to see this more done with the shotguns, but there's just no reason to use it unless for fun.
I want to see more done with the kinetic attack.
Oh, yeah, I'd love to see the...
I think it would be kind of interesting to see the Family Business go multi-class. I think that would be kind of neat to see.
I would like for it to be multi-class, because, like, it's not... Heavy is an interesting side grade, but it would also be an interesting side grade to say, like, Soldier or Engineer, for that matter.
Does this mean we can have Reserve Shooter on Heavy?
No. Oh, God, no.
Of course, you fucking double standard motherfuckers.
Why? Why would you not want to have reserve? It doesn't even have a purpose on heavy.
I mean, why would you not?
Okay, so why do you want the Family Business on everybody else?
Because it kind of works on everyone else. It's a shotgun designed to, like, not do as much damage but keep you in a fight for longer. And I've seen that as kind of like an interesting, like, the longer you play with it, the better it is. But in the short term, it's not as good.
Yeah, but you want to get your kills in the short term.
It's kind of like an opposite. It's kind of like an inverted panic attack, where it's good for longer. The longer you use it, the better it gets. But if you use it only in short bursts, it's not as good. Like the panic attack, the more you use it, the like worse it gets. Right?
Yeah, but the panic attack itself is, I mean, after Blue Moon, when they actually gave it proper good damage now, you know, 108 burst damage if you're at point blank, and a lot quicker than the normal shotgun if you pull it out. That's fucking crazy. Like, and I would like to, I mean, I'd like to see a unique panic attack variant for each class, honestly, because let's be honest, it's useless on Engineer because it's a primary. It's one that you want to be swapping.
I mean, on Soldier, I've seen it, like, there's this one person, I played on MGE with him, and oh my god, he, like, made this incredible combo with the Liberty Launcher and Panic Attack.
Okay, incredible combo and Liberty Launcher don't go together.
No, this guy was is actually insane, because, if only you guys saw him in action, because it was kind of nuts, because he could switch constantly, because he had the extra rock in his clip, so he can, like, switch really fast between the Panic Attack, go back to the Liberty Launcher. And since he has the extra rocket, he could do that for longer. It was kind of cool.
What? Wait, how does the extra rocket do that? Make what does that? Oh,
it just makes it like he could do
it
for a longer time. He could switch
yeah,
combo
saying,
for a longer
yeah.
time.
Yeah,
that was kind of cool.
Yeah, the Liberty Launch is kind of the principle of the family business applied to a primary. So yeah, I can see the point. Yeah,
it's still kind of weird, though, because like having, I mean, the extra rocket in the clip is handy, but it just feels kind of weird. You know, it's like. It's like having a fucking pebble in your shoe when you're walking. It's like, you know something's there and it feels off, but you can't quite tell just
it's
what.
It's different on the family business because the damage penalty isn't so severe that the extra ammo is almost irrelevant because...
like, if you combo it with, like, the Liberty Launcher and the Panic Attack, Panic Attack kind of makes up
for
it.
Yeah, but sadly for Heavy, there's nothing to combo it with, so...
You also wouldn't need the
I've
Panic.
Seen, like,
you also...
I've seen some people try a combo with the, like...
Fists.
Like, the only reason, the only, the gloves, gloves of boxing, that's the only reason.
Oh, the killing gloves of boxing.
Honestly, it's a fun little combo to watch. It's like, when you actually get the crits, it's really fun.
Oh, yeah, actually, bearded expense fisting you. Take that! Oh!
Well, actually, I'm honestly not gonna lie, I can speak to that too, because I, like all the rest of y'all know me, I use the panic attack pretty much religiously at this point.
Yeah,
but,
only because I started.
No, I actually got mine.
Started the whole trend.
Teemo's not even doing pyro shit much anymore.
I don't even watch Teemo.
When Jungle Inferno came out, he went like, "This is the new meta weapon." I'm like, no.
Yeah, I didn't do it because of Teemo. I did it because everybody thought it was a garbage weapon, and I thought I'm gonna prove them wrong. And
then
I bought a Strange Usual one for 85.
Well, when it was reworked in Jungle Inferno, it was still.
Oh my god, it's actually strange too. I thought it was just an
It is. It is a Strange Usual.
Yeah, we're not bragging about your panic attack. We're not bragging
about
you.
It's middleware.
Yeah, this isn't relevant. This isn't relevant.
You're irrelevant.
Oh wow, sorry, Rice Gum. Okay, we've gone on long enough. We actually skipped over a topic, but it doesn't matter, to be fair, because we're going to talk about general heavy changes. What would we like to see done with heavy as a whole in this update?
Weight loss.
What kind of overall class changes should heavy have? Like when Spy was given a speed boost?
That's really hard, because like heavy is just really balanced, but just boring. At this time,
I don't think any sort of personal changes should be made.
Like, he doesn't
to him.
Need any like big change in mechanic, like giving the pyro the air blast or like making Spy faster or something. He's just really solid and balance wise. But like,
solid as a class. It's just his weapon choices are not
like he's a specialist. He's not really viable because he's not as generalist as say like Soldier or Scout. Mm-hmm. But like in his role as a defensive. Kind of like as a defensive tank, he's pretty good in that role. He's pretty balanced as is. Besides the Tosser,
it's just, the deal with heavy is I think
he's just really good,
like
but just really bland.
He's always going to be a specialist because the way he's designed is that
he's
designed
to be a defensive tank.
Exactly. Yeah, you're never going to see a heavy doing offense very well because that's just how he's designed. And I mean, when you consider
in Highlander, you can, but like you need a whole
kinda,
lot of support for
but
him.
It's like when you consider that, you consider how exactly do we make specialist classes as viable as generalist classes, or are
I don't think they should. I think specialists, in my opinion, should be really good at what they do special in, and like have some generalists.
And would you say that heavy is the only example of a specialist done right so far? Then
for the most part, yeah, he's really good right now as he is. Again, he's perfectly balanced at the moment, besides Natasha. Like, he does his job good at being a giant wall of to soak up damage and to deal damage, especially even in sixes, may I remind you.
Yeah,
like on last.
I would say that maybe there might be some adjustment needed on maybe some of the other weapons to give them a little bit more of an edge towards what they are, because, like, how should I put this? Like, the Tomislav is a fantastic side grade as is, and it's a good weapon for offensive heavies and everything like that. But the Brass Beast is just... It's not really that interesting of a side grade that I'd call it really more or less viable. I don't see that many heavies running it.
It's just more
the same thing with the Hulong Heater. Like, they gave it a buff a while back, but it's more or less situational in its overall getup.
Even then, it's kind of like its only upside is like countered by the space bar.
Exactly.
Its upside is literally countered by pressing space.
Yeah, or maybe just standing on top of the heavy.
Yeah.
You know, for those of you Assassin's Creed fanboys.
Oh, okay, before we move on, TFG, anything you want to add?
I'd actually like to see his supportive role given a buff. I'd like to see his sandwich be able to throw more often, and I'd like to see that ammo reserve be added to the game to help out your fellow engineers.
What's the point? As in ammo reserve to give metal, not ammo?
It doesn't seem like he doesn't really need it. Like, his supportive capabilities with the, like, lunchbox items are pretty good as is. Again, he's really good with the medic for that reason.
You have to be careful how much support you give Heavy, because he's not meant to be that kind of class at the end of the day.
Yeah,
he's meant to be a defensive viable class.
Yeah, like, he's got supportive, but, like, he's using that to support the classes that, you know, support him, as in the medic that keeps him alive longer.
Because it's like, I mean, with health is a universal resource that everybody uses, so it kind of makes sense that Heavy could give that in some way, but metal is a class-specific resource to engineer. Part of the skill set of playing engineer is being able to manage your metal effectively.
Also, I don't really see, like, Heavy's teaming up with Engies. That's not really a thing. That's kind of like the only team I see with Engie is Pybros. That's a whole different
story. But there's also the fact that, like, allowing Heavy to give engineer, like, other than the fact that classes can just suicide to give metal anyway.
Yeah, and comp that, like, which, that which will is be kind completely of a, which, useless because like, in setup time you suicide.
Yeah, there's that, and the fact that, like, that's at least sort of a way to get around it with while you start to lose something, but it's like a lot of the skill set of engineer is metal management. So if you're just able to get a nice chunk of metal easily from the heavy without him even having to suicide for it, it just seems like it's giving you an easy way around the problem.
Alright, fuck it, man.
Unless it's on sixes.
Shut it!
Oof.
Give him a loose cannon. That'll help him out with defense and give him a good offense.
Wait, you want to see Heavy with the loose cannon?
I want to see Heavy with the loose cannon.
Oh my god, I would love and hate that at the same time.
Anyways, oh my god. Like, six is, like, Heavy. He's, unless, like, engineer, like, and Heavy.
Six is Heavy on, like, doesn't six exist.
Last, if they're on last, then you can make some use of it, but any other situation, especially in Highlander, like, NG's, like, usually pushing the car, doing his own thing. The Heavy's not really around them that much. Maybe beside the dispenser a bit.
Okay.
I want to think of a case like where like the NG went like, hey, yo, I need metal, and like the Heavy could go like, yeet.
Okay, so now let's get into the meat of Heavy Update itself.
The meat, as in the steak.
Shut the fuck up. What kind of new things do we really want from the update? What kind of weapons do we want? No hats. We're not talking about hats. What weapons do we want to see?
I want a JoJo hat for Heavy.
You've already got one! Right. What kind of weapon? We'll do one each, because I'm sure we've all got some kind of idea. What kind of weapon do you want to see with Heavy? And we'll start with TFG, because he needs a bit more time to shine, so to speak.
I want a large burst damage option like the loose cannon, specifically for Heavy as a primary.
Okay, can we think of something that's not the loose cannon?
No. I get what he's saying. He wants something that's kind of like the Dragon's Fury, for instance, is the burst fire option.
Exactly.
So,
just something fast and quick. Yeah, something so fast
like,
and hard.
It's like how people
fast and hard.
there's some mods that give heavy like this single fire air like anti-air rifle.
Wait, so are you thinking kind of like of the old like the beta version of the Huelong heater where it shot like big fireworks instead? Like kind of like a
no.
Yeah, that'd be cool. No, I'd actually like to see that because I remember that was originally going to be the Huelong heater.
Yeah,
that was
which you could like big
program.
Fireworks instead of like a continuous stream of bullets. So it shot projectiles, I guess. I'm not sure how that would go. Like,
I think it would be cool.
I think so, but I'm trying like to think like in competitive. I don't think it would be too overpowered in competitive. Highlander, like, Pyro could just air blast it or whatever.
And, yeah.
Like,
mean, like,
I don't see it being too much because since it's a projectile, it makes it easier to miss. If it does splash damage, also that would be an issue. Does it do splash?
I'd like to see them travel a certain distance in the air and then explode automatically.
So kind of like a detonator sort of thing?
Like a firework.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, it would probably go about...
I think that kind of be a bit cool. Like, maybe it lights people on fire when it bursts or something?
Yeah.
And that seems to be
well,
more
or maybe just
cause extra damage. It
seems to be more of a pyro thing to do, but...
Yeah, but like it's sort of like a flare gun minigun, where like it would shoot loads of detonator flares. Let's say they'd individually burst for a little bit of damage, but all of them adding up consecutively would do a quite nasty bit of damage. But yeah, the whole point.
Well, you could be able to dodge it, and if you're pyro, you can reflect it. So that's the way of countering it a bit more easier.
Well, yeah.
Since hitscan, you can't really dodge hitscan as
well. Yeah.
Well, it would be more like
a
minigun.
That's an interesting concept. I would see that.
Got it. It would be like a minigun that shoots detonator shots, but automatically explodes after a certain distance.
Let's go.
Right. Yeah. I tell you what I'd like to see. Now, I'm about to suggest a lunchbox item, but I want to see more lunchbox items that deal with heavy specifically, sort of like the buffalo steak. And I
like
had an idea
bar.
For... Shut up. The DeLocus bar is also for healing people, and so is the steak, sadly. But I'm thinking of a lunchbox that is exclusively for heavy. And what I'm thinking of is a bottle of vodka. And there is actually an idea behind this. You drink this vodka,
Scrumpy.
And for a short period of time, heavy's spread is tightened so that your accuracy is a lot higher.
So, Bastion.
Heavy's spread is tightened, huh?
Heavy's cone of fire is made a lot tighter so that your shots land a lot more accurately at a longer range. But during this duration, you'll also face some kind of debuff. So maybe you'll take more damage.
It makes you
or
slower,
something.
Maybe, because like it's vodka and you feel tipsy.
Yeah, that could be an idea.
Or it stuns you basically after it'll slow you down quite a bit compared.
Scumpy.
It'll slow you down quite a bit, and then when it wears off, you'll be stunned. Coming back.
It's like stunned for a second or two.
Basically, it's like a fucking it's a drink that turns you into pre-nerf Bastion. Okay.
Yeah, literally, it makes you spread that tight that you'd be at, that you can fire down at longer range. I wouldn't say a lot easier. Like I wouldn't make it.
So like a Tomislav on steroids.
Sort of. It's almost like giving heavy fixed spread, but not
okay.
quite exactly.
Okay.
I don't know how that would turn out.
A critical
of
the heavy.
Oh dear God, no!
No, not no. It wouldn't be more damage.
No,
it would be the same damage.
No.
It'd be the same damage.
Critical
it's just
for heavy. No.
It'd be the same damage. It'd just be a fuck ton more accuracy at the longer range.
Seeing that it's vodka.
I can see that. Like it's you're giving up crowd control.
Hang on,
ability.
TFG was saying
not
something.
No, it's okay. Talk over me again.
So snide. Go on, TFG.
No. So since it's vodka.
Jesus Christ.
Since it's vodka, I think it would make sense to like make the spread worse, however, increase the damage. You know what I'm saying?
Damage, no. Increasing damage on heavy is a bad idea.
The accuracy is getting worse, but the damage
seems like
is
a bad idea because I just get critical of flashbacks.
Yeah, and I don't know, I get the idea that heavy would be a strong drinker like Demo, so I don't know. Like, I mean, Demo literally does better when he's drunk, so.
Heavy has to be putting up with all that shit. Heavy has to put up with, has to drink with all the shit he has to put
That's
up
why
with.
He pairs up with Medic, because Medic's a brewer.
So, like, if it were to make the spread worse, what would be the buff in consideration about? I don't think more damage, because Heavy's already got enough damage, let's be fair.
Fire rate?
Fire rate? that's that.
Yeah,
that
like how many, like how many bullets is per fucking shot?
That kind of be
like,
interesting. Because
by
any
default, it's 4 bullets a shot. It's 4 bullets for every 1 tick of ammo. So, I don't know, fucking make it 12 bullets?
That would just spin up through ammo a lot faster. Well, that could actually be a good way to balance it. You'd like fire more, but it chews up ammo a lot faster. So
yeah, it'd basically be like a fire rating.
So the spread would be that bad that anyone at range would be safe, but you would kill people even quicker if they were close to you.
I don't know, it could be.
You'd Swiss cheese any poor scout that got within the 3-foot radius of you.
Well, kind of already do, though.
I don't know. That's a weird idea. I could see it being broken, but I could see it being, like, working. I don't know. Weird idea. But
okay, Alexa.
I like the, what was the other idea? The, kind of Huolong heater.
The Huolong firework cannon. Okay.
Yeah.
Alexa, yeah, like your idea.
Well, I have to say, as far as the heavy goes, he's got pretty solid options. He's got a defensive minigun, we've got the brass beast, we've got the offensive minigun.
Natasha,
and then
fucking offending all of you salty.
No, Natasha is just
Natasha!
Yeah, no. And then we have, I guess, a sort of situational support minigun with Huolong? I don't really know. But I suppose one of the things I'd have to say is probably, because a lot of the things that are overlooked in heavies categories a lot of times is either is mainly the melee weapons. So I would like to see maybe some kind of melee weapon that provides some kind of passive benefit for the heavy. Maybe I don't know, like something maybe like some kind of like the back scratcher from the back scratcher on Pyro, which the passive benefit being you gain more from health packs but less from medics or whatnot. So it gives you, it lets you be more independent. Well, I would just think it'd be a little bit more
interesting. Heavy's already like usually teamed up with a medic, so just kind of
right.
Like then what's the use of sandwich then?
I don't think
actually
heavy's
that
the
could
kind of
be
class
a,
should
that
be
could
independent.
Yeah, I don't think like roaming heavy just that kind of sounds like a bad idea. Like again, the whole like the pre JI urgently.
I own a strange and unusual panic attack. Every idea is a
no,
bad idea.
No, oh my god,
idea.
This isn't
okay,
about
first
you
off,
and your panic
I'm literally,
attack.
Like, trying to collect every single like strange weapon in the game.
Oh my god, this isn't a dick measuring contest. Get back to the weapon at hand.
I have a strange killstreak panic attack, so get fucked.
So do I. I also have a strange killstreak op.
Strange, nice. Unusual, Blizzardy Storm, Pampered Pyro. The only one in the game.
Strange,
there,
unusual, Green Energy, Patriot Peak.
Yes,
op,
but is yours the only one in the game?
It's no. One
my
of
Necro
four.
Headwear is the only one that's strange. As Neutron.
Right. Okay.
One of one.
But still,
make
yeah.
Make sure to check out my profile it's, picture.
But, anyway. But like, what kind of benefit do you want this melee to actually have? And what would the melee be?
Well, like okay. Benefits. Okay, so how should I put this? It would be more or less, like I said, like the back scratcher and whatnot. It would have that passive benefit of having you gain more from health packs, a little bit less from medics. Probably not as severe as the back scratcher itself, but maybe something similar. Or maybe perhaps rather than gaining health from gaining more health, you get more ammo from ammo packs instead as a passive benefit.
What's the point?
Because oftentimes when you are out there in the combat, you're going to need ammo. And sometimes the only thing that you have are these tiny little fucking mini gray boxes of only a fifth of your ammo.
Like, you can always just spam X plus 5.
Or you could always just kill someone.
Put dispenser.
Possibly, but
unlike health, ammo is literally everywhere. Like ammo
yeah,
is
that's
kind of
why like degreaser's like extra air blasting is not really a big deal because exactly. Ammo's everywhere. Like there's dead bodies everywhere, and like Highland, there's probably gonna be a dispenser anyways, or a cart.
I don't know. I just something that's got something that gives a more passive benefit for the melee weapon as a melee weapon would be interesting to me. I guess. I can't really say for sure, but I think it would just be interesting.
Right.
Think I gotta go now at the moment.
What?
Yeah.
Shit. Well, wow. Are we gonna have to... Okay, then. We're gonna have to go without you.
I'm sorry.
Bye, sauce.
Okay, just remember that. Okay, for my weapon that would be added is a bowl of tubby custard. Bye.
Okay, you know what? We're done. We're done. We're fucking done. We are done. We've pretty much all, except that cunt, we've all given a weapon that we'd like to see. We talked about heavy. We want heavy to be more fun. That's basically the only thing we're saying. We want heavy to be more fun and more viable.
I'd like to see the frontline update for heavy. I think that would be a good idea.
Oh yeah, frontline.
Yeah, that would be a cool update. That would be a cool idea. A fucking World War II fucking esque heavy update with all sorts of guns, things like that. You know, fucking. I'd like to see something new for all the classes.
Yeah, if you know me, you know I'm nuts about World War II themed games, and yeah, I think that would be great for heavy, especially since he's from the Soviet Russia.
All right. On that note, we'll call it time here because that's pretty much all we've got time for. We've talked about the heavy update. We've talked about heavy. We lost someone because they're stupid and lazy and hungry for tubby custard. And yeah, so this has been the cup of coffee you will know and love. Yes, me, Minty Coffee, joined by the ever loving, ever present DJ Alexis Oderia.
Yeet.
And Mr. TFG.
It's been fun. Check me out on After Hours if you want to see more of me.
Hold on a second. Insider trading, excuse me.
And subscribe to the Prison Podcast on Twitch.
Wow, I think we've got a conflict of interest here.
Subscribe to the Prison Podcast on Twitch for Retire United Antics.
Well, that's it. We'll see you next time, sexy compatriots, on another episode of Minty's Monty.
Goodbye.
Later.